English or Italian?
Both.
Okay. Welcome to Aviteca. This is a third year saggio. It's the result of a seminar. È risultato questo saggio che state per vedere di un stage sul lavoro di New Trial, nuovo processo. Perché il nuovo processo? Praticamente Peter Weiss, l'autore, prima ha fatto sua versione, molto fedele, al lavoro di Kafka, Franz Kafka, The Trial. E poi, prima di morire, before dying, Weiss felt the artistic necessity and the human necessity to add some of his own thoughts and experiences to The Trial. Prima di morire, Weiss ha sentito questa necessità a livello umano, a livello artista, di aggiungere i suoi pensieri, in qualche modo aggiornare The Trial. Questo sarebbe stato negli anni '80, è morto e ha lasciato questo pezzo che io non lo conoscevo prima. I didn't know the piece before working on it, on The Trial. It's a very complicated piece, è molto di grande complessità il pezzo, con grande opportunità, pure difficoltà, linguistico, assai. Qua ci siamo a vari livelli di inglese, we have different varying degrees of English competence. You know, some people came here 3 years ago and didn't really speak English at all. Other people came here and they were all almost mother tongue. It's an enormous, very, very useful challenge for an actor. Cioè, enorme, particolarmente utile come sfida per l'attore a recitare un'altra lingua. Qua a nostra scuola ci puntiamo molto sul gioco tra azione e testo, che vuol dire, va bene, hi, how are you? Allora io dico, ciao, come stai? Ma lo dico con modo tipo, oddio, sono scocciato. Questa è la differenza tra testo e azione, e lo puntiamo molto su questo attraverso un metodo. L'attore che si mette con la sfida di recitare in un'altra lingua ottimizza questo gioco al massimo. Immaginate voi a fare un testo che tu non sai neanche che vuol dire, ma lo devi intendere lo stesso. Questo è il gioco tra azione e testo, parola. Questo testo è un'enorme sfida. Punto di vista mio sullo spettacolo è un esperimento. Qua ci siamo arrivati e poi mi hanno aperto pure il mondo, pure gli attori con loro proposte. C'è molto puntato sul loro azione, non solo da attori ma da regista. Infatti è proprio fondamentale lo stage, questo imperativo. Per parlare per prego. Se non vi dispiace cominciamo a spettacolo. Have a flashlight. Share it. Somebody else wants the flashlight. This is kind of fun. You know how to use that?
Yeah.
Very good. Excellent. Any questions?
No.
Domande? Non ci sarà. Ok.
Thank you.
Making the needle move. Now it's our breathing. Now it's some footstep on the street. Now it's your heart. There is nothing else. And now it's the door. As I said, Mrs. Krobach, there is no quieter building than yours to be found anywhere.
If he were in the country, he'd be writing about the birds. Engineer, come here. Kindly switch off the birds for me, please.
Yes, he only has to call and we come running. I woke up 2 hours early this morning, went without breakfast just to help him.
That's perfect. Then he shall have breakfast with us. After all, it's his birthday. We want to celebrate. Happy birthday to you.
He's sitting around behind closed curtains.
Leave him alone. He's always working late at night.
Working? All he does is reading. And for Christ's sake, reading again. Is that work?
Sir, would you like to join us?
Take me, for example. I live above the fire station. What a racket there is at night. People sliding down the poles, into the tracks, out they go, sirens blaring, the water racket. And let me tell you, I've even grown used to it. You get used to everything if you just want.
And I miss life in the barracks. It's not right for an officer to live at home. This place makes me feel like I'm already retired. But perhaps things will get started again soon.
You mean there'll be war?
There's been war everywhere for a long time. Show me a continent where there's no war.
But those aren't real war.
Just skirmishes.
There are logarithms about. What's it called? Struggle for liberation. Liberation from what?
And then they start beating up on each other right away.
Yes, a real war is something else.
Yes, something that demands your whole allegiance.
When I think of the last war.
Two great wars in my lifetime. I was still a child in the last one. My father, he got killed in it. And now there'll be another war?
My dear aunt, that's the way of the world. Look at history. The Greeks, the Persians, the Romans. It's human nature. That's why there must be soldiers who defend the country when it's attacked.
Yeah. No, Mr. Cifatoni, just think. The director must think a lot of you. They sent two workers and an engineer.
Mr. Camino is really very efficient in the company. I heard just recently that he's to be promoted.
Yes, yes. His boss values him. And why exactly don't we accomplish just as much? But only here is the chief attorney is indispensable. Without him, the whole department would collapse.
And if he's such a good worker, then he should also take care of the TV as well. He always brings some work from the office, so he shouldn't be disturbed. And the house belongs to the company. After all, he had to leave his old room. We all had to leave the beautiful apartment, and you know that, Mr. Kaminer, and not everyone finds such a change easy. I always say, it's such a big company. If he says it's for the public welfare, then it should be there for the family.
The public welfare! The truth is, the company has to pay itself. Good luck. We'll be late. Let's go, boys. We were supposed to finish things up before working hours.
Oh, dear Lord. You're not safe anymore in your own city, are you? We should definitely bring in the military.
Everything. I explain it to myself. Everything should have an explanation after all. There shouldn't be any misunderstandings.
And then everything seems to frustrate you. You've been so long now in my house. I always used to say to my husband, we could never find a better and friendlier tenant than Chief Attorney K. He disturbs nobody. Does nothing to harm anyone, and everything's upside down. He has to break his own back trying to fix everything.
No, no. It's only sometimes like that in the morning or late evening or at night. It's easier, much easier during the day. The day is just fly by.
Really? Mm-hmm. But often when you come home, you start asking questions. Where's the captain? What has the captain been doing? Where is Miss Bernster? Isn't Miss Bernster home yet? And my late husband, really, he liked company, but it was too much even for him when you came running right away to his bedside and start asking, how are you today? Have the pains gone at last? Are you feeling good? But he knew how things were with him. He'd known since the war. Never recovered from the war, you know? And when he died, you wept as if it had been your own father.
You see, dying. That's not that I'm afraid of death. That's not it. But death is the other. at the same time is always there. At night, I try to imagine what it's like to be dead. And since your husband had suffered so much, you see, this suffering, I deal with it every day in the insurance department. The whole point is to find a remedy, to make things easier. That nothing suffices, that nothing can be solved. However, everything is perfectly arranged. Mrs. Kruber, the better my work is going, the less it can achieve. Do you understand?
I understand, but don't take it so much to heart.
Please.
Look at you. What a good looking man you are. Good work, good income, and the women. They are crazy about you.
The women?
Yeah. I keep my eyes open. Here in the boarding house, ladies come and go. But you've fallen from his birth. Listen, you need someone you can marry, someone you can make a home with.
Mrs. Grubach, to you I can say this. Miss Bernster has something I haven't found in anyone else. I don't know what is it. Perhaps her eyes or her voice. In the evening, I wait until I can hear her voice through the wall.
Oh, so that's why you're always up at night. Because she always comes so late.
Mrs. Grubach.
It's late, it's high time, you must go now. No one there can knock in at your birthday. But in a business like this.
Various departments. Secretaries ask for you. You know how many meetings there are now? And when you say after closing time, no one notices. You are only here when you are seen. My closing time, most things are settled as far as we are concerned. What counts is the morning.
That I was late today is due to disagreeable matters for which the company is really responsible. Disturbances that keep me awake all night.
But the people have already been sent out to you several times. The director himself gave the instruction to our construction company. Everything's been done that can be done. Besides, it's only a transitional stage.
Mrs. Armistad, you're mistaken.
I tell you something. You are always talking about how people's lives should be improved, how we should do more to fight misery. Now, misery is really being eliminated. A new world is coming. But as for you, I think you're basically a stick in the mud.
There is no transition. Everything is completely fixed. A single system. In my previous apartment, everything was just as it is now. I suppose my standpoint has changed somewhat, but my view is the same. Of course, everything makes new demands, but the situation is the same. And you, Mrs. Rubensteiner, you also remain the same.
It's from the Progressive Party.
Do you belong to this party?
Oh, me? I don't belong to any party, you know that. The company is enough for me. It's more than a party. When you think how much scope it gives you, how many people it employs, but you, you want everything into one category. That's why you look around the party and certain meetings here and there. You'd like to be politically active. It seems to me You always complain in order to make trouble, to stir things up. No wonder the party sent them to visit to your home. And you! You waste your time with it.
Keeping informed is part of my job. The material sent to us by study groups, societies, and parties doesn't concern me alone. That's where the general interest begins. From letters like this, I understand what's preoccupying people out in the world, outside our operations.
I'm certainly not claiming that you are not knowledgeable in our affairs, I mean inside the insurance company. But what do you know, for example, about the real estate market, about transportation? You know about our main affiliates, but what can you say about the relationship between various managing groups? You want everything secure and regulated. You only turn to the central office when it's a matter of your trivial personal concern. What are your guys?
Mrs. Frankensteiner, it's completely the other way around. It's what's fixed and secure that makes me uncertain. It's solidity and order that makes me want to question everything. Not that I don't want order, I want order, but a different kind of order. How can I explain that to you? I want a real order, an order in which everything makes sense.
Yes. Yes, just to get so worked up. Anyway, it was only a joke. Oh, don't you understand the joke anymore? You're alone too much these days. Yes, you are always sit around on your own. When I call Miss Gruber and ask for the chief attorney, she always say, she's not available. Why? Is she sick? Does she have visitors? No. She's alone and doesn't want to be disturbed. What does that mean? That's what I meant when I say that you don't live in the same time as the rest of us. Oh, but now, I'm the one preventing you from walking.
Expired a long time ago, as far back as New Year's.
Have you paid rent this year?
No.
Not for the past few months. The man from the office, Mr.
Kaminen,
no. He told us to come back. He told us that the company was responding to our needs with a special account.
You would have to renew the rental contract.
So it is back to the office? Who should I ask there?
I will take over this matter. Leave the paper with me.
No, I will not let the contract out of my hands.
It can be done without the contract.
We will move into a new apartment as soon as possible. Are you really going to help us?
I promise you. Mr. Kaminen! Mr. Kaminen!
Yes.
Mr. Kaminen, there must have been a mistake here. Make sure that this woman is paid the compensation due her. Mr. Kaminen will take you to the cashier. Trust me, be patient for just a while longer.
This morning, I hardly said what I felt about her eyes or her voice. I must describe all that to you. It's more the shadow under the eyes. There are a few fine lines at the corner of the eyes. When the eyelids are lowered, they have a blue sheen. The voice. When I hear the sound of that voice, I just know that it's something capable of changing my whole life. But even doesn't describe it. The eyes, the voice, those are just signs.
The person who sits at me, what a strange person. They asked about you. They were insisting on going into your room. They said it was still something to do with the ventilation, but I said no. No one is allowed into the chief attorney's room, not when he's not there.
Did they give their name?
No.
What did they look like?
Well, they were pretty intimidating.
Miss Bertner, did she act familiarly with them?
Yes. I mean, perhaps he put her hand under his arm before she went with them into her room.
They went together into her room?
Yes.
How long were they with her? Did they come together or were they visiting her?
I don't know. I was in the kitchen. They just called me after a while.
Had they been here before?
No, I don't think so. I've never seen them before.
We're taking our summertime walk.
Yeah.
And these guys hiding out here. Just as I thought. We're walking by the river, past the castle, the sun is setting, what a sky. And we say, the chief attorney, he's bound to be sitting in his office. He sees nothing of the sunset. And when he comes home, it's already dark. He missed the red clouds.
The red clouds.
He saw nothing, because he always walks bent over. All he sees is the pavement and his worn-out shoes.
Leave him alone. He's tired.
Tired? If he's tired, then it's tiredness from too much sitting. Nothing tires him more than doing nothing but sitting. If I had him as a recruit, I'd be teaching him a thing or two.
Yeah, Mr. Chief Attorney, we've been thinking about you. You're such a recluse. Well, I always wondered, what's he really thinking when I was feels guilty looking at you? It's as if you always knew better. I think you're reckoning you're something really special. The way you always keep to yourself.
Miss Bertner, I don't want to be all on my own.
And then when you say something, it's as if you haven't been listening at all. You just keep staring straight ahead.
Miss Bertner, I'm looking at you.
You're looking right through me.
Yes, that's quite right. I've been mostly listening to your voice. When I hear your voice, what I'm really hearing is its sound.
I must repeat, I'm really sorry I don't have you down on the parade ground. You'd be a really good training fodder.
Oh, Miss Bersner, you chose to speak to me. I never want to talk to you directly. I always wanted you to talk to me first.
Mr. Chief Attorney, I've been just put up with such a treatment.
Mr. Chief Attorney, how can you put up with people like us? You're really too good for us. Please, Mr. Chief Attorney.
Miss Bersner, I'm speaking only to you. I want to tell you something. There's something in my life, like an unending struggle. No, there are times of waiting in between. Yes, in fact, it's mostly waiting. And then comes the struggle. Then come the blows. And then I'm waiting. Again.
Always of the greatest value, and this time you spoke from the soul when you say he should be promoted. Mm-hmm. Indeed, your talents are not properly utilized here.
But sir, I really feel at home here. I couldn't achieve anything better elsewhere.
Always modest. Always modest! You have no idea what you could truly make of yourself. You're to be transferred to the corporate headquarters. There, you'll have real possibilities for development.
Sir, I'm working on so many cases that I want to follow through on the responsibility I've assumed.
That's just it! Few people in our company are as conscious as you of their responsibility. And on that, I am at one with the public prosecutor when they say the more responsible a person is, the greater his responsibility should be. How few there are who have what it takes to lead. To direct! How long have you actually been in this office?
2 years, sir, and before.
Yes, yes, I know. When you came to us as a young lawyer to our legal department, I could see right away. The future belongs to him. He has that open gate.
Not for nothing did he study with me. Yeah.
I don't know whether I can accept your offer. At headquarters? No, I don't belong at headquarters.
But Joseph, you're just right for headquarters. That's where you'll be in your true element. Even as a young man, I remember how you were raving to me about how you wanted to know the world. And I told your father, Joseph, he's got greatness in him.
Miss Huster, things right here are already too big, too complex.
I know. It's been tough for you in recent days. How could I have left you in a ledge like that? Would you like us to provide you with a new apartment?
No, absolutely not. I'm very comfortable in the apartment. To move now would be impossible.
And Miss Hazera, reminding me that yesterday was your birthday. How could I forget that? Yes. In appreciation. Okay, next week you wind up all current matters. And make sure Mr. Camina understands the job. He'll be taking your place. The sooner you come on over to us, the better.
Aren't you glad about your promotion? It also means a salary increase.
I don't need more.
One always needs more.
Miss Huster, You know that I didn't really want to leave the legal department. With legal questions, you know where you stand. Everything is structured. And then you advised me to go over to insurance. And you said there would be paragraphs and laws there too. But everything was more elastic.
More fluid, hence more interesting.
I had to learn to read the truth on people's faces. All I had to rely on was my own intuition. After 2 years, I'm finally able to judge when people are speaking the truth.
My boy, that's why you're no longer in the right place.
Studying faces, that diverts you.
I'm finding out about myself. I've discovered what I want and what I'm good for. Miss Astor, to move to headquarters is really out of question.
You can't do that to the director.
Miss Astor, were you in my apartment yesterday?
Excuse me?
You know, how's possible that you have such influence on the director?
Well, dear boy, I know a thing or two. I have some things under my control. The director has no choice but to listen to my advice. Later you'll understand that, but to do so you'll need more insight. Joseph, I followed your career. You have the capacity to formulate and summarize issues. Your monthly records are of high ethical value. One could almost say they like poetry.
Poetry.
At any rate, they're too good for a sub-department. They should benefit the whole enterprise.
Miss Austin.
Your idealism. We could use more of that.
Listen to me, Miss Astor.
Why do you address me so formally? We've been on intimate terms since all days. Oh.
Hello? Yes, I received the letter. On Sunday. I want this person. This icon drive. And I don't want that, and I will warn three countries. That's the right ticket. It's quite far.
Yes, it will be there.
So early. Yes, at 9 o'clock. Right. Bye.
What do you think you can get from me? What's your stake? How much are you ready to cut back?
I don't understand. I expect nothing.
Do you know what kind of position I have?
You're secretary in the bank.
Really? So I am the secretary? Dearest, do bring me my dressing gown.
Do you want your slippers too?
Yes.
Miss Birchner, I wanted to invite you for this evening.
Yeah.
Oh, Miss Montag is welcome to come too. The restaurant.
So, you want to invite us? Can you afford that?
Miss Birchner.
So you really don't know who I am?
At the office you are spoken of with great respect.
My indeed. Dearest, tell the chief attorney what sort of position I hold. Miss Bresner is head of the bank.
Come, you see? You too, you can't imagine that. Head. That's just not possible.
No one told me.
No. No one talks about it. Sometimes I'm called chief attorney. You haven't even heard of that. As chief attorney, I will hold the same rank as you. I can rise that far, it doesn't bother anyone. But head of the bank, that's kept quiet. For negotiations with other banks, however, I'm the ones that sent out that I can shine, that I must shine. I render their other directors speeches, and then I can do business.
Why don't you claim your status here, sir?
Hold up! It's not against any rules. Who could have anything against it?
Oh, indeed. No one except the CEO.
But you have your rights.
What rights do I have?
You have all the rights of, and duties of which you are entitled as head of the bank.
I have the right to strop the CEO's shoe with my foot under the table when Danny at his house.
Miss Burstner.
You men get whatever you need. You, as a bachelor, are accustomed to take for yourself whatever female happens to pass by. You thought I was a mere office employee. It would have been easy to cope with the tactics.
Miss Burstner, I've never treated a woman.
Oh, so much the word. Anyway, what is there to be negotiated between us?
Nothing, Miss Burstner, nothing. You've completely misunderstood me. We work in the same company, Miss Burstner. I would have wanted to talk to you. Wanted to trust you, Miss Bushman.
And now you no longer trust me?
No. Now all it may be different. I must look at you as my superior.
You could transfer to another department and maybe rise a rank there. Perhaps you could become head of it. Would everything then be different again?
Do you know Miss Astor?
Who doesn't know you?
I'm to be transferred to headquarters. I don't want to go to headquarters, Miss Burstner.
There, come over to me at the bank. Would you like to work under me?
No. No. I want to stay in the insurance division, Miss Burstner.
You know, it annoys me to see how you always act as if you were real ambitious and then you don't move from the spot you're in. Sure, you're a cultured man, you surround yourself with books and art. When people walk into your room, they become almost reverential. As you read all that, I wonder, as you study all that. And in the daytime, you work just like the rest of us. Yeah? I almost admired you for the strength to do the things after work. I just never had the time for it.
You have a greater responsibility than I do after. In the evening, after our office closes, you surely have many.
There we are again, talking about my plans. As for all these, as if it's worth far more than your work in the business. During the day, you really only do trivial things. You don't want to rise professionally. You don't want to become head of the department because you despise all that. Because you belong right here. Tell me, what do you really do here? Sometimes it seems eerie to me. No, I feel disgusted when I hear you moving about in here at night.
These books, Miss Burstner. These pictures. They help me cope.
Would you like to be an artist yourself?
I don't know if I could.
If you were one, what would you create?
I don't know. Maybe if I knew, I'd be able to do it.
What is it about art that attracts you?
The other.
What other?
Thing that's different from everything around us.
Like that?
That which is in the middle of it, especially.
Like
yeah.
Death.
Like death. Like death. Death is like life. It's greater than we are. It outlives us.
Kiss me then.
No, Miss Birchner. I can't.
He can't! You with your weaknesses! Take a look at this mountain instead. How I love her infirmities.
Change. We've had enough of the politicians' incompetence. Now, it's time to begin something completely new.
Yes! Progress! People don't think nearly ever that!
Progress!
What's that word mean?
It means moving forward.
Yeah, moving forward.
But from where?
From where?
From where the politician starts moving!
But he's a politician himself.
She says something about rising up.
Rising up?
We're not rising up like rebelling.
But fighting in the streets and all.
More like
a spiritual rising up.
You'd have to give these words
a new meaning.
Think more when feelings have it, Putin.
Feeling, that's the true voice of reason.
And in us, it's been distorted.
By the politicians, the technocrats, the experts.
Say what you fear.
I feel that I'm hungry.
You must spend your time just on the material questions.
No, on things like faith, justice, love of humanity.
But they talk about those things in the other parties too.
Recently in the Equality Party.
Hello. I am here, friends.
In the Brotherhood Party, they talk about truth, hope.
It's true that he led it to the experts.
Parasites, he called them.
Who are spreading everywhere.
Who think they're so potent just because they studied something.
And peace. They talk about peace. Peace above all.
It's always family about peace.
And it sounds like a threat.
Yes, you watch out, they don't use the peace.
They want to make us a threat.
They say we don't know which way to turn because of all the danger.
So that will be the sign.
And then they talk about cat box.
Oh yeah, cat box.
Why are fewer and fewer people needed?
Why more and more is being produced.
And well, the others decide that.
What others?
Well, the others who can see farther than we do, who can have the big picture. It has to do with the business climate, with the market.
He's probably from the Revolutionary Party.
The Revolutionary Party has also gone bust.
How are we to know if this is the right party?
It is the right party. Why? Because it speaks to all levels of society. It doesn't represent any one particular group or class, no. It responds to all who are no longer assigned to the present state of things. The party's success can be seen in the range of people assembled here. Look around you. We have all kinds here. Wage laborers, craftsmen, white-collar workers, people from the welfare office, housewives, officials, future directors. Unfortunately, you came rather late. Much too late. You heard hardly any of my speech.
It was a long way. It was difficult to find the street.
You should have gotten up earlier. I suppose you're not used to getting up early. But the point is, you came.
Our friend here works for the United Society for the Public Welfare.
I was ruined by them.
You see, the fact that people like them find their way to us prove the correctness of our program. Renewal, as we mean it, can only happen when it answers to the desires and needs of everyone. We know that we have to live together, that we are connected, connected by our love of peace. And if we now show the politicians how numerous we are...
How are we to show that?
By making the party strong. Become members. You can sign up over there. There you get the membership book.
Can anyone become a member?
Anyone. We make no distinctions. Young or old. Rich or poor.
What does it cost?
You can afford it. Less than a movie ticket.
And what do we get for it?
What you yourself achieve. You're the ones that make the party. That's progress. Nothing is done for you here. You must do it yourself. Everything comes from you. That's what rising up means.
Hey, what's wrong with them?
Yes, it's from the insurance office. Don't you feel well?
It's hot. I can get an ache.
Oh, he's very ready to help. He promised us an apartment.
I need an apartment too.
Leave him alone now.
Has Willem gone already?
No, he's over there. We're in front.
Would anyone else like to sign up?
Hurry, Kelly, to text the coordinators.
We must go now. To say what? No, it doesn't help.
Well, really, what a Sunday. The one free day we have, and morning is already sharp. It's so late to start anything in the afternoon. We should have made use of the whole day.
Because my sister died. I love him. Wouldn't you like to eat?
So your nephew was already with you as a child, and then?
He was with me until his military service. And then, when he became a captain and was allowed to leave off the base, he came back to us. Yeah, my husband was still living then.
Eat up now, please.
Really?
We could be like a family since you said that I'd be like a son to your husband.
Did I say that?
The captain and I. Brothers.
Yes.
Mother Grubach. I've often wanted to call you that.
And your own parents? I never see them. So you seek out other parents?
You know, that family stuff growing up with parents and siblings, it's really nothing but a damn nuisance. You live grand together and never get free of one another.
I left home to find my own way.
But it was immensely difficult for me, I admit it. I admit it, Mrs. Grubach. I find it very difficult to cope with my life. Do you understand me?
The soup's getting cold.
You see, in my profession, I deal with vastly complicated matters that always have a direct impact on other people's lives. For a long time, I simply did my work, and then suddenly that wasn't enough. Since then, I've come to know the consequences of everything I do, and I wonder what lies behind everything that influences me. You stay a while, Mrs. Grubach.
But then you must promise me to eat up.
How am I understand what goes on in the world when I can grasp the meaning of everything that happens right here? Today, I was at a political meeting. It was all about things that are important for our lives. But I just couldn't take in any of it. I felt helpless.
There's nothing special here. I always feel like that when I'm all alone.
But it's precisely when one is together with many people that one should be grasped more than a single individual can.
One should be able to see what really counts.
I had a thought. Now I mean it would be revealed. No more color just isn't enough for me anymore.
Yes! Perhaps you're in the wrong place. Perhaps you should try something quite different.
Yes. Yes, Mrs. Grubach, what you say encourages me. I really will reach a solution. Then, just for a moment, I sensed that the solution exists. And that's already a lot. I'm going to go after it immediately.
Storeroom for files.
da puttana!
In English.
No.
But yeah. In English.
Things that have cost me years of work.
But you know that we've introduced a new system. The simplified procedures mean that what used to require a sizable team can be accomplished by a few workers. You yourself had become superfluous.
You, with your card files.
It's those card files that matter to me. They bring human beings, you had a particular case, closer to me.
Everything can be accessed by the new system. My dear fella, you were our museum piece.
One must listen to everyone. Robin Sainer. One must talk with everyone.
Certainly. People are our central concern. Our reputation is based on that. Yes, you are always full of understanding, but you are also made too many commitments. You made too many promises. That was the mistake.
Insurance was our most respected undertaking. We were known for our personal involvement with our clients.
I'm not our bank. Our apartment buildings, our reputation apartments just as respected. You were given plenty of leeway. You react to the slight discord and not by the losses. I suppose it didn't bother you at all.
I insist that I be kept informed concerning the affairs of the insurance department, that I receive responses to my inquiries.
Why, of course! That's why you moved to the headquarters, to broaden your perspective.
I see you already hard at work. That's as it should be. Yeah. Yeah. When you file away some in the papers, you can take your tour of the facilities. Your secretary will ask you. And Miss Hazelrad is also already waiting to confer with you. People don't just rush in on you here. It isn't that. Are you ready to receive Miss Hazelrad?
That's really important. Never forget the role of the outer office. It's the job of people there to take the pressure off you.
Maybe sister come in now?
Oh, yes! Please.
And ran around the room in his nightshirt.
that I'm alive to hear that. He said, if you knew how he loves you, you, his only son.
And?
Aren't you going to ask after your mother?
My mother?
She's blind. Your mother has gone blind.
Blind?
A year ago, but she's forgiven you.
Forgiven what?
That you deserted her. That you've never returned home. That you've never sent her any news.
What should I have?
Can't you imagine what it means for parents to lose their son? Always to have to ask to others how he's doing, what he's doing. It's really time for you to visit them.
I can't do that.
But Joseph, think how important cohesion is for a family. You're the one who always talks about mutual understanding, about the need to listen to others, to help others.
It wasn't possible there anymore.
Wrong, Joseph. Wrong. You're the one who was needed. You, with your insights into things.
My insights? What drove us apart? Whenever I saw things were in the wood, they wanted to talk about it and push me away. They'll get us mixed up in doubt, they said.
They wanted just security. Then you were afraid of what might happen.
I was taught to play with the boy who frightened me. I was not allowed to spend my time with the girl I liked, because the boy came from a wealthy household while the girl's parents were destitute.
They were afraid of what might happen.
They did visit poor districts.
They wanted security.
Yeah! They wanted to be secure, respectable. They wanted to keep disaster at distance, so they attracted. Disaster is painful. Well, it fears it and denies it, that's what sticks out. At the end, it became part of us. Every word was stamped by it. There was also some tenderness and gentleness.
And that's when you should have provided comfort.
I? When a disaster was written all over me, I could see what was really happening.
I don't understand what you mean, Johnson.
What do I mean? I mean the way we people that were everywhere persecuted, hunted down.
Yes! Yes, but all that isn't happening here. That's all far away from us. There's no reason for us to worry.
It's pressing upon us all the time.
But Joseph, really, we can't live like that. The fact that somewhere people are still hungry, that doesn't have to spoil our appetite. That there's destruction going on somewhere, that doesn't have to take away our pleasure in building something. I fully respect your concerns, but you help no one with your laments about the general reason. Help with improvements in your immediate circle. Now you have the opportunity. You've done right to obtain an influential position for yourself. Only the person with influence can intervene and change things. Cheerfulness, my boy! Cheerfulness is what's needed now. The whole world is opening to you. Yes, there are pockets of poverty here and there. Big pockets, even. You're right about that. But now, it's your role to illuminate them. You're one of the pioneers, the new colonizers. A new colonization has begun. No violence. No, never violence. An economic colonization combined with spiritual power. You belong to the new elite.
I can't see myself that way.
You learn to do so. That's how it is with all knowledge. One discovery leads to the next. You've never been obtuse. I remember how effortlessly you moved from natural law to commercial law, how purposefully you worked in the insurance department. I hardly need to tell you that you know your own capacities. You just sometimes let yourself be distracted by this tendency, a tendency that I'm convinced your secretary will help you to cast off. I hand you over to her.
I'm gonna catch your name.
Call me Lane.
promoted to. I'm on board at that quarter.
And I'm in the back.
This prisoner thinks a lot of friends.
Can I fit in there? Do you think I'm stupid?
Why should I think you're stupid?
And I think most people are stupid.
I do.
And what is that? A month ago, when we were at your place because of the band, you heard something we couldn't hear.
I'm still of the opinion that there's nothing wrong.
The director said there must be something wrong if you say so. And everything is stupid who doesn't understand what you mean.
If you are promoted, that means that people can't think you're stupid. We could have been fired.
Yeah, forces the look that told we'd be fired.
There must be some reasons why we weren't fired. Your captain workers. You're the divisional leaders one day.
Yes! Yes, yes, yes!
Yes.
Now I got it. You and I and everyone else, we've always been prosperous. I began as a messenger of transportation, then moved to construction, then to maintenance, and Miss Wilson.
Miss Wilson began in our patrol office. Then she was a typist in production, then a cashier in the bank, and now she's a bookkeeper there.
And you? You began in the legal advice office, then an insurance. Soon your problem will be on the board, or somewhere else.
Somewhere else?
Well, I'm not saying you become a window cleaner or a sweeper, but I know someone who was an engineer and now is a stalker.
Mr. Willem, do you think I'm not suited for my position?
Oh, what is better suited? These things on your desk, I don't know, look very funny to me. As if your desk is not here, but somewhere else. This guy, with old-fashioned cap and moustache, it's new to administration. I'm only asking, I don't understand anything about it.
He was a miner. Was he your grandfather?
No, he was someone. Someone with himself a palace. A palace? Not really a palace. A palace deep underground. The promenades, the galleries, and pillars. Everything upside down. Circuses down to the top of the tower. Everything made of clay. He worked it with his hands. Stone pressed into them, lumps of coal.
Did he live there?
No, he couldn't live there. Too good a palace and not to live in it.
He lived in a hut nearby. But he spent all of his free time inside his construction. His whole life was always making it better and more beautiful.
And everything upside down.
Everything rising downward. You couldn't see from outside. He built for himself a monument to you. A vault.
Is this all? With the rain?
Talking about stones and graves.
No, about art. I am to direct the art association, so I thought it good to prepare the ground a bit to stimulate the aesthetic senses.
But the art association is not supposed to take up a plus talent during working hours. You are the exception, of course. You have to carry out the purchase of art to select the appropriate walls for them in the offices. Yes, it's your job to worry about beauty.
Mr. Robert Steiner, I've been thinking about something. You know, no one of us has a firm position here. We got used to a particular workplace, we got moved elsewhere.
Correct! We'll move around!
Yes, but the fact is that we don't decide that to do that ourselves. We just got shipped from here to there.
Because the work activity is to stimulate the whole person. What this individual often doesn't understand is the push to do so by management. That's all employees' talent can be utilized. I call it revolutionary approach.
Yes. I probably do feel freer myself. I'm beginning to see the overall project.
You won't change your shabby boarding house room for something a little more prestigious.
No, I want to stay where I am.
Is the sound gone now?
everyone from Freedom Party to Quiet Party. Which party is it today?
The Revolutionary Party, right? What section of it?
Which one?
You never know that in advance.
But so many people come anyway.
That's just it. The fact that nothing speaks is what attracts most people.
There were a lot of police outside.
With a cannon, we're just around the border.
The police are always there when there's uncertainty. The more people are meeting, the more police show up.
The previous time, at the Progressive Party meeting, I didn't notice any surveillance at all yet when the subversive matters are propagated.
The stuff about the people rising up. But the people are expected to rise up themselves, they are being to raise up. Behind the Progressive Party are official networks for the education system.
As far as I could understand, the talk there was also against education. Against education.
That's normal. A fish in line with a hook is first thrown out. The first, the ones who are supposed to buy are those at least know that they know nothing. The ones who feel themselves to be cheated, who think there are others who know more than themselves. These others, the ones who know more, are the nouns. That they know something you, the audience, doesn't know. That's reprehensible. They must have obtained such knowledge illegitimately. The person who by this line will talk, he's hungry, and above all, and around the rest. The ones who don't buy, who don't become agitated, there's no point fishing for them. And to the ones on your line, you can say, now it's your turn, now there's something you can learn. And the first thing they learn is to despise the kind of rotation from which the world is blue.
But if your eyes higher, you must have something ahead of you that's enticing.
The bait is already lodged in their throats.
Are they chuckling?
They're not supposed to notice it. The bar is stuck in the roof of the mouth, and then they are pulled upwards. Finally, there are an open hair.
What kind of hair? In the brief, then?
They're you. They're driven together to a meeting.
They come on their own accord, wouldn't they?
After?
All these people. An easy drive there. Something got wolfy. They want to get together. To improve their life.
They are being lured here. Lured together with everything at all. Either the ugly shortage or too high rent, either poverty or sexy taxes, either idleness or overwork, either loneliness or family crisis, they are made completely empty. And then they wait for someone to say something to them. And when they get to know a little bit about how things are, then they believe they know everything. But the terrible thing is, they don't expect enlightenment. They expect kindness.
But it's a basic huge thing. How can others who think prevent people from thinking?
They don't prevent them. They teach them to think in a particular way. Yes, they always want to teach us stuff that's got nothing to do with us.
Aren't you from the Revolutionary Party?
The most revolutionary thing you can do nowadays is to look at one's own condition.
If people really look, they'd sure see something. I clean up the field and the vomit at the train station. I'm dead and conscious people lie around there, buzzing stuff and pumps into their veins. I drop them out. Even the place where we live, no one left there anymore. Look at my husband. They are my helpers.
Hasn't your apartment been signed to you then?
This is just how you are! Promises! Promises! And nothing ever happens!
Long ago
they did everything for you, or they didn't ever heard of you.
First thing tomorrow, I promise, there's been some misunderstanding.
Misunderstandings! There's always some misunderstandings! How can you even run your operation without these misunderstandings?
My worthy listeners! I will tell you what is to be done.
woman. Elderly will display a unique cohesion.
Everyone has to commit his energy where he is needed.
Democracy means freedom. Tomorrow ties. Everyone should be open to everyone else.
Everyone must learn to cooperate with everyone else.
We learn our own on that basis.
Yes, a perfect community of interests.
Our institution will stand unique in the marketplace.
If there is any competitiveness, then selfishness is also suspended. We will all serve in the public good.
No, not entirely, Joseph. With your inventiveness, you can help our group of companies to expand still further. Growth is beginning on an international scale. So, we're talking about cartels and trusts.
Those words are outdated. The leadership of the colony is at stake. We're talking about political leadership.
We are more than a political party.
The art, my dear, is essential to our politics.
And you understood all that precisely because of your experience in suffering. You let yourself be tormented by all the existing perfection. You kept a constant lookout for the other possibilities. The kind of general possibilities.
Because
it's a very good fella, because it's a very good fella, because it's a very good fella, nobody can deny.
And so, we find out our way to this new model. One man in the unity of profit and self-denial, of authority and law over humanity, of art and politics, in short, of reason and emotion.
Don't you remember? We conversed once about the vision of a society based on reason. We have been discussing the brevity of our revolutionary approach. Before they could come to fruition, they were destroyed, disintegrated from within. They've been overthrown, malign, martyred. Never as stable as our society at anything established itself.
Doubtless, you say that we too, with our policy of constant transfers, achieve only fragmentation. People are alienated from themselves, become helpless tools in our hands.
But the best proof that that's not the case is you, yourself. You said you want to become an artist, a poet, and you are one, in a higher sense. It is the expression of life itself that attracts you now. And now, you're realizing a dream. You're working with the stuff of life itself, with the most contradictory artistic material. You're truly inspired.
A new kind of human.
Because...
I want to know the condition from which your project emerged. It was so hardly established that it's not changed. Now.
As it changed everything when you put on the headquarters, after barely 3 months you're put on the board, what a ride!
What a ride!
Yes, you moved to a villa. Travel. I've already set up the program.
The purchase of artworks is still to be done. Only you can do this. Huh? As you know, wall paintings for the new public reception building.
What happened if these pictures were to hang in our reception building?
Meaning what?
Would I break the place to bits, or would a place extinguish the pictures?
A fearful struggle would take place.
But we will win.
The pictures will win.
And the process lose, because the institution must always be in the right. They could have an impact on our dealings, no?
Do you still believe that?
Oh, I believe it until now. That was sustaining. I wanted to come as close as possible to the colossal strife in Sargonor everywhere. Now I no longer believe it. We never get beyond a certain point, and perhaps that's where all the imagining begins. Focus on something visible, tangible.
You mean I?
How you say that, Isorelli? With such amazing indifference, as if you were the most self-evident thing in the world. Yes, that's how you're able to endure life.
It endures me. My task is to oppose life. I get around in it. Get something of it for myself. Rip something of out that he doesn't want to give up. That really doesn't belong to it. Something we usually just aim for but never grasp. And it's the one thing we can truly possess. Totally and absolutely. It's a violent assault on life. I read!
And yet, it went beyond itself.
You think so? It's only a substitute.
Substitute for what?
For life itself, of course.
But you can get true from life.
True. I don't know if it's true. Life doesn't contain a truth. I paint something as a consolation. When I can no longer keep looking at life as a whole, I sit there for hours, weeks, dozing, when I paint a yell, shriek, and sob. Often because of my tears, I can see what's coming into being.
That's what we call clarity.
Oh, beauty.
For me, it's fear, scum, span of suffering. Everything bleeds. Their entrails. It's shit.
How can you come across like purity?
Because you want to see it that way.
No. No, there's something really there. Look. Look at this. Oh! Now I destroy something of yours.
No! That's how I want it. Yeah. That's how I want it. Look. Everywhere. Traces of hands. When I sketch on the beach, I get people up from the street. People from the bar, from the harbor. Sometimes I pull a driver out of his truck, stuff money in his pocket, drag him with me, press him up against the canvas. I want everyone to participate. They know it's rarely, often they come of their own accord. Begin a brush, thrust into their hands. Here, this figure. Is our savior. And the two female figures here? Oh, yes. Do you recognize them? One is a bank employee, the other a cripple. You see, they're naked. I press them into the colors. See? Stomach. Sex. Thighs. I draw their faces in wonder and raising.
They cried out to
while I was weeping. Yes. A single lamentation. Wouldn't you also like?
Not yet.
Not yet.
No.
Not yet!
No.
Not yet, but you don't like you! You feel the urge to participate with your aunt man in the depravity of art!
Is it depravity?
Ha! Is it depravity? You know very well what the answer is.
Your little friend? See too. Ask her. She'll tell you.
Hey, do you know? Oh, please. Take her. I've been sent to guard you. I know everything about you. I know your most secret impulses. If you fall, I thought you. How can you know everything about me? You've been in a head office. Didn't you see that every detail is preserved there concerning everyone comes even briefing contact with the company? Every step you've taken, every one of your utterances preserved, even your future actions are already being calculated based on the possibilities that lie within you.
And if it is something that couldn't be predicted,
then you have to become completely empty, to renounce all meanings. But it's impossible to you to give up searching for a meaning.
If you were to do that, you'd be where I am.
It's empty here. Absolutely empty. Nothing can be predicted, but you don't dare! That's it, sir! You're afraid of what might happen to you. Lady could explain it to you better. I can't. Whenever I try, I'm overcome.
Afraid?
too easy. It's as if I will leave something out. And then the act itself will be superfluous.
The children any longer. We were told you were about to leave on a trip, so we thought.
Then you wouldn't disturb you if we.
Shall I call the police?
No.
Listen, if we could stay here for a while,
we
just.
We could also clean up for you.
And then the worst. Who are they?
The men.
We're never ready!
You should have gone to the director's place. There is no room there.
Oh, but we wouldn't be letting him there.
You can stay here!
What a disgraceful behavior.
That's his family.
You can stay here! We can stay here, please. Please, we can stay here.
Thank you.
and Kashan through it tonight. Gotham is nice to have some best situation.
We make transfer primarily from the transport sector. So that's where our most reliable
people. Now that our attention is paid to the resources available to us in the military, soldiers have learned to act in a brave and disciplined way. Bravery, I say, is a quality that needs to be properly appreciated.
Miss Lance, I don't underestimate your officers, but don't protect the decision of the economic and military skills sold for a double security measure. And at the same time, the entirety of the project must be kept in good.
Yes, sir, Mr. General.
Now we are here. Now we can really talk with each other.
But we can talk here.
You're not alone in your room either.
There's only McCaffrey in there.
These people here are also very close to me. Here we can say everything.
How can you expect Miss Grubeck to accommodate all these people?
Pay the rent for all of them.
What did he actually do?
They're horrible people. They conduct the business.
What kind?
They collect rags, wash the rags, sell them as dust rags or clean clothes.
Can you imagine I would confide my secrets to you in this place?
Now let me begin! Miss Bustner lives separated only by a wall. I hear each of your steps just as you hear mine. I hear the rustle of your clothes. I hear when you lie down. Consciousness is filled by your existence. Merely being in this house, your presence builds me up. I'm much more strongly feeling the place where we spend the day together. Yeah, there we are no longer protected, but bear responsibility for something that has become immensely important to us both. If we are close neighbors when we are here, there, we are completely bound to each other. Here, a whisper is a little bit like a provocation, but there, in that palace, you compel me to an involvement that is like an inner upheaval.
I don't compel you, wife.
When something defines my life to such a degree, it must have a point of origin.
It can come from me in a different direction.
It comes from me alone. I am constantly wondering, what is your hand doing now? In what direction is it pointing?
That has nothing. Nothing to do with you.
And your mouth. What words is it forming now? What orders is it giving? What truth is it speaking? What lies?
I never lie.
You lie incessantly! I keep trying till I'm almost in despair to hear something true from you, Miss Burston.
We're both caught up in something that's basically hostile to us. That wants to destroy us, and for which we nevertheless working tirelessly as if we wanted to race even faster to our ruin.
Do you want to rescue
me? You have arrived at such a close relationship with each other. How are we to stand up knowing so much about each other? We can only imagine we'd stand our lives still further to where we belong together, are bound together, so that you and I constitute a doubly strong force. For that is the only way we can blast our way out. Together.
Pain when the horror all around us is growing.
Because it
When everything is only becoming heavier.
At least for the moment, isn't that enough?
No. Relief can only truly exist when you know it will enter.
But isn't that enough to sense that possibility?
It would just be deception.
Why would it be just deception?
Because it can only be an escape, and that would contradict the result we expose oneself to another.
It's not contradiction. And it is not a contradiction. It is not a contradiction to make a sign point to the suffering that will tear you apart. It is not a contradiction to make eternal what will destroy you and will disappear in an instant. And is it not a contradiction to love what destroys you?
What should I do?
You should give yourself completely to your terrible love. Even if it is
with the weak.
It must be directed at me since I feel it so strongly. But then he says she couldn't do anything with her power because she came from poverty and living the slum areas where he himself will never go. And now he wanted to rescue her. To rescue her with her power. I'll make your power on my own, he cried. Give me your power. Bestow your power upon me. And what does he call that? Love. He holds out this love. Perhaps it really is love. For him. He talks about her strength. But really he wants to rob her of her strength. Wants to see her become weak, yes! He can only love someone even weaker than himself. He throws himself before her in order to use her to build himself up and then to push her down into the dirt. And because none of this works for him, he turns to someone who he knows is stronger and will remain so. He can't get at her with love. Not with his kind of love. He begs her to tell him what to do.
Don't let her get away!
Life together, as well as justice and freedom.
Chains, and one of them is sitting by a stake about to be garroted. He's said to have painted that one himself.
Which are you saying? Which picture? I didn't see that one at all. Is that right? Did you paint it?
I did nothing. Nothing.
Titorelli.
Nothing.
Titorelli! Is it true that others helps you with the painting?
Yes. Everyone helps me. All armies work on every picture.
This man too?
Yes.
He too. And you. And the American over there. And the general. Yeah, the general. And this one too. He was at my place. Wanted to pay me everything alone. And that one especially. You can't even show what they painted.
So, where is the picture? The one with the prisoners.
What prisoners?
He is about to be executed.
What do you mean?
Sitting in chains, by a stake.
That one! Ah! The worker! You beat the worker! Ah! He's working on a road to sitting on a rock. I don't know anymore if he's holding his breakfast roll or his big bucket.
He mentioned armies. Armies. What did he mean by that?
To emphasize that respect for humanity is the trademark of our endeavors.
Especially now, with increasing arrests everywhere.
When daily, we must strengthen the image of our alternative way.
Just as the director in his speech emphasized our ideals.
They simply cannot be invoked often enough.
And by us. The enemy is using them also. We must present them even more convincingly, so that it becomes clear that truth is on our side. That's right, General. Yet I must admit that we, even though we are, as they say, in a driver's seat, occasionally feel ourselves to be.
Yeah, not the slightest doubt must be permitted to arise that we are the one who guarantee peace.
As an artistic person who's been thrown into politics, however, I must repeat that behind us there are power capable of snatching away from us all the plans and programs we produce. I mean, powers against which we are helpless, that perhaps reside within ourselves.
Is it not precisely this humanistic principle, this capacity for self-criticism, for questioning everything that's been achieved, this spiritual freedom that makes you, and of course us, your allies so superior? For I too, who now really assume in the office of economics minister, I know that existential uncertainty of which you speak. To live with this uncertainty, I'm constantly to overcome it. I'm to give a political meaning to this overcoming. That is where I see our strength.
Your Excellency, it is truly admirable that as we contemplate a new era of expansion, you should remind us of our human weaknesses.
Gentlemen, I cannot see the future as often than the way you paint it.
In the freeze of pictures.
Yeah, just as I say, nothing good will come from these pictures.
As people who think in shape and the world around them, however, they must suffer from a prince. The division is a reality not only with us and with you. We find it throughout the world. On the one hand, there are the enlightened ones, ourselves. We only desire them. On the other hand, there are... How do you call them, those who live in ones?
Joseph, I'm sure that most of those words come from the depths of your heart.
And the other zone is depression, gathering disaster.
Which is to be prevented.
Why, with us, there is this monstrous and seemingly unshakable order, which gives us security about that also. Since we have an inkling of the catastrophe lurking behind it, makes us sad.
And all that serves to strengthen us in our ethics, our morality.
Alas, the prisoners of our philosophy. For all the wisdom we imparted were, our hands remain tied. We cannot, on our own initiative.
initiative for the Empire of Peace and Freedom, however much we'd like to do so. Let me say it clearly, we must work against ourselves. We must do so by enabling the world to see through us, to confront us with our errors and failures.
Your Excellency, you express yourself in a simple democratic manner.
It's not ready to elect.
For us, it is a new beginning.
And, Your Excellency, we have assigned the office of director to someone in tune with yourself in his sensibilities and religious convictions.
Thank you. Nevertheless, I wouldn't say the word must.
That's why words must be strengthened. People are living this for too long. That as a demoralizing effect. People say, who came from a war? Dangerousness of the enemy must be made clear.
But some journalists are leaving us in the lurch.
Oh, come on, we've been too gentle with them.
Yes!
I don't forget how strange spaced intolerance. There must have been the appearance of suppressing the freedom of speech. Rather, must have meant absolute freedom of the press. There are other suggestions to my direction on this.
Your Excellency, there is more and more evidence of a sense of impotence. It's as if people wanted to hide themselves away. Only rarely do you still find an individual expression of opinion.
Brats! We've gone too far with our threats and warning. Don't people believe us about the crisis anymore? True. People accept pay cuts and downsizing in order to save other jobs. But the lights are still on, the trains run. There's still enough to buy. People aren't accept. And ultimately, we must have the cooperation of the majority in order to save our system.
I will still like to say that the planning indication of our new director were of great value. He's the one who recognized the exhaustion, the decay of the opposition. We hardly needed to intervene. The fears and the slander were carried out by the people's oppositions themselves.
All we did was intensify the atmosphere just a little. Then we could hold these vacillators, these eternal weaklings, came over to our side. Are many of their leaders with us today, who were reviling us just a few years ago?
Our tactics are correct. For a while allowed some latitude of the movement of...
How shall I call them?
Yes!
Of the wretched ones! We've granted them a few small victories and successes. Thus, the attention of the most restless wolves diverted, far away from domestication, toward a new distant revolutionary goal. So, when the heroic idea seems to be attractive, these people have to face both everyday desperation and unpleasantness of organizational matters, the supporters' idea was quickly lost. As always, when there are no weapons.
For our spirit, these men said the emotional excesses of youth are useful for time to time. Our serial urge to do something fizzles out, and that mystifies it, as our director often remarked, to pick out a fine organ to exemplify to them the general adversity of resistance.
And how is the army of our people going?
We have continued the equipping of the workforce. The training is of the athletic variety, only a small proportion have real gun duty. Most are in a welfare office, communication system, housing,
not so much detail.
But they don't arouse the slightest suspicions at work.
Stop talking about that junk! Our task here is to concern ourselves with great strategies. The goal is to replace the antiquated conception of equality with a new, legalized conception. What suggestions does our director
up till now, we worked what we still possess of the director's instructions. Unfortunately, they've recently become rather sparse. I say unfortunately, because I'm worried about him. Mr. General Director, perhaps it would be possible for me to win back again completely for our...
Are the problems that exist between you cleared the way?
Oh, there's now absolutely clarity in the bank's affairs.
It had been delayed because the central security system was being installed in the bank.
Because the people entrusted with the security had to be especially reliable.
Then, my dear, give it a try. Take him with you right away. Let's lose no time.
Talking to me.
Yes. Now I'm ready for you. Yes. The racket shot. Of course, you were the boy with clean stockings, while I went barefoot, dressed in a sack. But in the extent of our humiliation, we are not different from each other. You wanted to have me down in the dirt, but now you can have me among the fence. For that's how it had to be, my little one. I had to rise in order to be a match for you, and you had to fall in order to do me justice. Now, we can unite, for the misery was endured was the same for both of us.
No. No! That's not how I want it. Not here. Not here.
Not here?
No.
In the bank?
No.
But not in your place either, among all your garbage.
We must look for a third.
There is no such possibility. There isn't. It must be here. You saved it yourself. We've needed into this institution. We've conquered something jointly. Here we can become strong, powerful.
We must leave this place. Leave this place. We must leave this place, Mr.
We can't leave. We can't get any further. Only here. Only here can we overcome everything this day.
Here! 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 It's possible! With corpses everywhere! Shooting on the street! Listen! Listen! Listen how they scream! Listen how they run! And then? And then, Miss Bershner! And then they fall! Here, we are prisoners.
Only here! Only here! We are safe!
Stay here, Miss Awarda.
But that peace! The very peace you were looking for!
Ooh.
My son! How could it happen, son?
Let it be. Mother. Let it be.
Yeah! Ha, ha, ha.